What's going on, guys? It is Power Bang. Welcome back to another Brawl Ball video. I say Brawl Ball because that is all we're focusing on in this episode. We're going to look at every single brawler in the game and rank them in order of which you should use on Brawl Ball and which you might stay away from. First up on our list today is Piper. Piper is used to being one of the best brawlers on game modes like Bounty and Smash and Grab. In Brawl Ball, however, she simply can't put out enough pressure to thwart off an enemy attack. With the slowest reload time in the game, Piper is not the best option for Brawl Ball. Next up on our list at number 17 is Ricochet. Like Piper, Ricochet is a long-range brawler that does his best work when standing far away from the enemy. In Brawl Ball, it's not necessarily the wisest choice for your brawler because he simply doesn't have enough health in order to be competitive. With a very limited health pool, going up against brawlers like El Primo and Bull is very difficult because they do not have to respect your damage because he doesn't have enough of it to put out. They can close the gap on Ricochet and take him out with ease. Up next at number 16 is Pam. Pam has a decent-sized health pool that allows her to get up and down the field while surviving the inevitable onslaught from the opposing brawlers. However, Pam's primary function, support for her teammate with suppressing fire and healing, is a little bit less than useful because her healing station stays put and you can't take it with you up and down the field. When the ball moves away from that healing station, Pam becomes a little bit less than useful. Next up at number 15, we have Crow. Crow is a little bit of a mixed bag on Brawl Ball, and in the right hands, he can actually be a pretty good brawler. His downfall is that he does not have a very high health pool at all, and he can quickly be taken out by an aggressive enemy player. One of the big benefits to Crow on Brawl Ball is that his primary attack applies damage over time to the opponents, and that can force them to retreat to try to regain health, get out of combat, and make sure that they stay out of range of Crow. If you're good at managing distance with Crow, you can actually pressure the enemy team to where they're dangerously close to their goal. But due to the fact that he has such a low health pool, I've got to rate him kind of low for Brawl Ball. Next on my list is Poco. Poco is another support brawler similar to Pam in that he can heal his teammates. This actually comes in quite useful, and he's rated above Pam due to the fact that his healing is mobile. He can take his heal with him and use it as a super anywhere on the battlefield. Poco's downfall is that he does not have a lot of hit points, and he also does not put out a lot of damage. Because Poco's attack penetrates, he can actually come at different angles in other game modes to do a substantial amount of damage to the entire enemy team. But from what we've seen on Brawl Stars so far, those angles are hard to come by as most of the maps are fairly open, so he's kind of a free target for the enemy team. Next up on our list at number 13, we have Jessie. Jessie's an interesting brawler on Brawl Ball because she has an extremely powerful super, her scrappy turret. That turret has an extremely high rate of fire and a very significant output of damage, but the trick is, can the fight take place near enough the turret to make it useful? Because of the nature of Brawl Ball being an incredibly mobile game, no pun intended, the brawlers will actually go up and down the field, possibly avoiding that turret altogether, neutralizing Jessie's super. One other spot where Jessie does very much excel in this game mode is at the beginning of matches. When people approach the ball, Jessie's orb will actually bounce between all of the players, and it's very common for all players to rush the ball at the opening point of the game. Anytime players group up on the enemy team, Jessie can knock them down incredibly fast with her shock orb. At number 12 on our list, we have Dynamike. Dynamike is a fantastic brawler to use for Brawl Ball, but he's almost a victim of his own success. He is super good, however, he's got a counterpart in Barley that it just makes sense to use more on this map. I'll describe why later when we talk about Barley. But talking about Mike, Mike is fantastic at controlling areas of the battlefield, limiting the ability for the enemy to approach you, and that really kind of cools off those aggressive, high hit point enemy brawlers like El Primo and Bull. In addition to keeping those brawlers kind of held back a little bit, he can actually support his teammates and help them get the ball into the goal by dropping dynamite where he knows the enemy has to go to defend their own net, so to speak. In addition to being very good in area control on Brawl Ball, Dynamite's super also can destroy obstacles. That point cannot be stated enough, and that goes for all brawlers. Any brawler that's able to destroy a crate or a box and open up line of sight to the goal, that is extremely valuable and will allow your teammates to possibly score score a goal with a super kick later on in the match. Just outside the top 10 at number 11, we have Colt. The All-American brawler wasn't quite sure what to make of this guy at first. But after playing him some, it's apparent that Colt is a force to be reckoned with in Brawl Ball. His primary attack puts out a ton of damage, and if he can target those big-bodied slow brawlers like El Primo and Bull, he is one of the guys that can knock them down very quickly. In addition to Colt being an absolute wrecking ball with his primary attack, his super attack is one of the most devastating attacks in the game for any brawler. And it's not just the deadliness of that attack to other brawlers why that super is so effective. He can also, as Dynamite can, destroy obstacles. That means take out those boxes and crates that are guarding the goal. If Colt can line up his shots and use his super so that in the background, behind his target, he can also take out those enemy boxes, he can be very valuable to any Brawl Ball team. Our first glimpse into the top 10. At number 10, we have Brock. Brock is not a brawler you typically associate with being one of the best in the game. However, on Brawl Ball, he can be quite a force to be reckoned with. His shoulder-mounted rockets that he fires are absolutely lethal to enemy brawlers, especially when they group up in the middle of those matches, going after the ball in the beginning. Because it doesn't take too many shots from Brock's shoulder-mounted rockets to generate his super ability, there is often a hailstorm of rockets coming down all over the battlefield for the duration of the game. In addition to doing a ton of damage, Brock also can take out a very large chunk of the walls with his super ability. This opens up line of sight to the goal, allowing his team to be able to score. After one of the recent balance updates by Supercell, it's no doubt that Shelly has seen a decreased use rate across all game modes. However, I have her at number 9 for Brawl Ball. Shelly is a very well-rounded brawler, as most of us know. She can put out a lot of pressure on the enemy team, and due to the cone-shaped spread of her shotgun pellets, she can really hurt large groups of brawlers all at the same time. In addition to having a fantastic primary attack, her super ability is also not one to underestimate. It can flat out smash enemy brawlers, but more importantly, it can smash enemy brawlers while taking out the enemy wall, guarding their goal in the background. Opening up that wall will make it easier for her team to score later on in the match, and ultimately could push her team to victory. At number 8, we have another common brawler. However, her performance on Brawl Ball is anything but common. We have Nita, and it's really the story of Nita's super, her bear that puts her up this high in the rankings. That bear is essentially like a fourth player added to your team. Because it hones in on the enemy position and will target the nearest enemy brawler, it's very important to pay attention to the direction that the enemy team is forced to go if they want to avoid damage from the bear and avoid Nita recharging her super because the bear is landing shot. Long story short, Nita is one of the few brawlers that has a companion as a super that's able to take it with her. That bear being able to walk anywhere it wants on the field puts her in a category above the others like Pam and like Jesse. Finally, in addition to Nita's super, her primary attack does penetrate her initial target, so it can do a significant amount of damage to enemies grouping up to try to get the Brawl Ball at the beginning of the match. Nita is a solid choice for Brawl Ball. Up next at number 7, we have Terra. Terra is a new brawler, and she can do pretty much everything well in Brawl Ball. Her primary attack penetrates opponents and can do a substantial amount of damage. Because it penetrates, she can hurt the whole team relatively quickly, especially if they make a play for the Brawl Ball in the beginning of the match. One of the things that really sets Terra apart, though, is the use of her Gravity Super. Gravity is one of the few supers in the game that can actually reposition an enemy brawler. This comes in incredibly handy when trying to aid your teammates in getting to the goal, or if you're trying to pull an enemy out of hiding into line of sight of your teammates so they can help you take them out. One other very clear reason I recommend Terra is because she counters one of the most popular and effective brawlers in the game mode, Mortis. I found that Terra is a decent ball carrier, having a moderate amount of hit points. She's great at the trick of passing the ball to the opponent, quickly taking them out, taking the ball back, and continuing on her way. As previously mentioned, her Gravity Super can destroy obstacles. If it's dropped right on top of the wall, it will punch through an opening, giving your teammates another option to approach the goal. I highly recommend Terra in Brawl Ball. She will be dominating battlefields near and far. One of the best brawlers in Brawl Ball is Barley. He comes in at number 6 and is a master at controlling the battlefield. Barley has an area of effect attack that he drops on the ground that will tick twice to any opponent that walks over the top of it. We talked a bit about Barley earlier in that Dynamike is very similar in mechanics to Barley. However, Barley does a much better job of controlling the battlefield. You can use your primary attack with Barley to isolate and eliminate brawlers. You can also move people out of position by forcing them to run in a certain direction. This makes it very easy for your teammates to score. I would be remiss if I did not mention Barley's ridiculously strong super. He can throw a blazing inferno of bottles all over the battlefield. It has a huge area of coverage as well as immense damage. He can take out the entire team with this super, opening up a path to the goal with your brawlers. And we've cracked the top 5. At number 5, we've got Spike. Spike is a legendary brawler, and he does a fantastic job of putting out a load of direct damage that makes it very hard for the enemy to approach your goal. In addition to the substantial direct damage, he also has spiked projectiles that fly off of his main cactus attack that can damage a whole lot of people that happen to be grouped up in an area. Where Spike really shines in Brawl Ball is the use of his super. Stick around, the cactus patch he drops on the ground will keep opponents glued in place, making it very, very difficult for them to get anywhere near your goal. Spike is the ultimate when it comes to keeping people locked down in a certain position. I highly recommend Spike in Brawl Ball, as his ability to control the battlefield with his super is unprecedented, as well as his ability to put out enough damage to stop nearly any brawler in their tracks. Spike is a brawler that must be respected. At number 4, we have Bo. Bo is running rampant right now in all game modes. His recent buff and one of Supercell's balance updates has made him probably the best brawler in the game overall. The big reason for this status is his super, To Catch a Fox. That is the mines that he lays down on the ground that are triggered when an enemy brawler walks over the top of them. He now has 4 mines instead of 3. Not only do these mines do devastating damage to enemy brawlers, but they also recharge his super ability, meaning that if he lands a shot with those mines on the enemy brawlers, he likely has more mines to throw down directly after the ones that are currently down are used. Because of this, Bo is able to completely lock down the battlefield, controlling popular choke points, and even using his super to destroy the walls covering the enemy goal. Bo is a fantastic option for Brawl Ball, and he pairs well with some of the top brawlers that are coming up next. He's back with a vengeance. At number 3, we have El Primo. El Primo was made for Brawl Ball. High hit points, extreme power, ability to cover a lot of ground quickly with his flying elbow drop, the ability to destroy obstacles with the flying elbow drop as well. You can make the opponents drop the ball, you can knock them back, you can reposition them. There's a whole host of things that El Primo can do and do very well. His only downfall on this mode is he has very little range, but we all know that about El Primo. There's nothing different about this mode versus any other one, and he's well equipped to take his team on his back to victory. There are 2 brawlers that we haven't yet spoke about. One of those is Mortis. Mortis comes in at number 2 in the Brawl Ball countdown, and he is an absolute beast at this game mode. When looking at Mortis's skills and abilities in comparison to the other brawlers, he really doesn't grade all that high. He has one single mechanic that grades him out above all of the rest except for one, and that is his dash ability. Mortis's ability to get around the arena very quickly sets him apart from all of the other brawlers because no one has the speed to keep up with him. Although he can't use his dash while he's in possession of the ball, the trick Mortis often uses is to kick the ball slightly ahead and dash to it. That basically gives him turbo speed while moving up the side of the map. All it takes is for the enemy team to get wiped, or if a couple of them die, Mortis can take advantage of that situation, press the issue, and get to the goal before they even have a chance to respawn. Highly recommend Mortis as one of the members of your team comp, regardless of who you're playing with. Last and certainly not least, as evidenced by his number 1 ranking, is Bull. Bull is a rare brawler who is a rough and tumble character armed with a shotgun. Like El Primo, he's got a substantial amount of hit points and can pack a heck of a punch when up close and personal. Bull does everything well in Brawl Ball. Bull can cover distance quickly with his super. Bull can quickly take down enemy brawlers and enemy ball carriers. Bull can carry the ball himself. He's got a ton of hit points and he can withstand a lot of fire. Bull's super can charge right through obstacles, breaking open the wall and opening the pathway for your team to score. Bull Super will also knock back an enemy ball carrier, forcing them to drop the ball, wasting precious seconds. All things considered, Bull is a fantastic choice on Brawl Ball, and I choose him as the number one brawler out there right now simply because he has very little weaknesses. Even against a ranged composition, he can absorb a lot of shots and act as a distraction while your other teammates get into position and go for the kill. Thank you guys so much for joining me for this episode of Ranking the Brawlers in Brawl Ball, Supercell's brand new game mode. Feel free to screenshot the screen right over there. We do have all of the rankings from top to bottom, Bull all the way down to Piper. Let me know what you guys think of these rankings, and if you agree with them in the comments, who would you move up or who would you move down? Let me know. If you liked the video, please drop the sub, and I will be back for more Brawl Stars action in the future. Take care, guys.